Mr. President, dear colleagues, a week ago, the World Federation of Trade Unions held in Brussels, inside the European Parliament, an important international trade union conference about the consequences of the workers' and trade union movement of the policies of embargoes, blockades, and discrimination imposed by the European Union, the NATO, the USA, and their allies. The participants of the conference showed with evidence that these policies of the imperialists against people are and countries have always the workers, the youth, the women, and the pensioners as their final victims, depriving from millions of workers the hope that they can build their future with dignified work. It was also showed that the embargoes, blockades, and discriminations have nothing to do with democracy and freedom. These wars are used as an excuse. In reality, we are talking about competition within the capitalist system for competition and contradiction within the imperialist system, which happened for the control of the markets, the definition of new borders between countries, for the new energy pipelines, for the profits of international corporations and of the monopolies. So, as a result of the imperialist interventions in Iraq, Libya and Syria, for example, thousands of women and children died in the Mediterranean Sea. For all of those people, dignified war remains a mere declaration. As a result of the ongoing and long-lasting blockades against Cuba, the peoples of the whole world are deprived of the great achievements of the Cuban Revolution in medicine. As a result of the blockades and the policy of Israel against the Palestinians still don't have their own homeland with East Jerusalem as capital. As a result of the sanctions against Russia, poor farmers from Greece, from Bulgaria, from Serbia cannot sell their produce while Russian workers are losing their jobs. As a result also of the discrimination against Iran or Venezuela, for example, the peoples in other countries are deprived of cheap oil. Another thing that shows the hypocrisy of the imperialist in that from the ILO list, often some countries, for example, Colombia, Israel, and USA, are missing. In these countries, governments violate basic human rights since trade unionists are assassinated. There is discrimination even concerning who will enter a public transport bus in Palestine, in Israel. Policemen who kill African Americans firing without any reason are acquitted. The World Federation of Trade Unions that celebrates this year's 70th anniversary will still be continue in all international forums intervene based on its principles, its internationalism, the values of international solidarity. It will continue standing by the side of the people of Venezuela and the efforts of the government of President Nicolás Maduro Moros. It will support the fight, the right of the Syrian people to decide democratically for themselves on their present and future without external intervention of thousands of foreign mercenaries from the five continents. We will continue to demand the punishment of those responsible for the death of 48 innocent people in Odessa, Ukraine, when a neo-fascist set building of the trade union in Odessa on fire. We will continue to express our solidarity in practice with the imprisoned trade unionists in the prisons of Asunción in Paraguay. We demand the release of our cadre of WFTU, trade Union leader Huber Ballesteros, who is until today in prison in Colombia. We are ready to cooperate, coordinate and support peoples and unions who are victims of blockades. We must fight together to stop the blockades, embargoes that aim to plunder the natural and economic resources. Thank you very much for your attention.